Echo, yeah, I think I'm gonna have to. Echo is too. I'm gonna have to log out and come back. Make camera audio. Sorry, people, let me log out and come. The echo, is it still there? Oh dear. Can you hear me now? Yeah. There we go. Now, can you hear me, Abdul, please? Just tell me. Abdul, can you hear me now? Is the echo gone?
We send it to Uganda. We call out on Uganda. No, be anyone. So, come and coach over Gamba and people.
No, nope,
Saga
nope.
Rose is in Mamba Gamba. You know, Zika.
Thank you. Thank you.
Proud
nope,
Ugandan.
Nope.
Yes,
truly proud of Uganda.
Yeah,
this is our country. Teddy Wakawalala. Naichi Muchanjagala Oktegizawa na Uganda. Tuli no kumanyanti. Politics are governing abuli part of your life. Nti.
Yes, sir.
Politics is in your livelihood. Day to day life. Nti. Sukali gogula. Politics ya salawo. Transport gosasula mtaxi, politics ya salao. Rent gosasula landlord wo, politics ya salao. So fena fena wa na Uganda, okwagala eggwanga lyaffe, tulina okukyusa obukulembeze bw'eggwanga lyaffe, ne tuteekawo abakulembeze abalumirira eggwanga lyabwe, abakulembeze abaagala eggwanga lyabwe. Mukirabye mweno time ya corona, singa daladala abantu abatukulembera bali balumirira omuna Uganda. Kirungi kati mukirabye nti politics ya salao buli kimu. Tuli waka kubanga bakulembeze be twalonda bwe batyo bwe basazeewo. So abo be mulonze bwe basalirawo ffe kati tulina okwebereramu nga tuteekayo abo abantu abasobola otubeereramu
yes.
Abalumirira Uganda. So bana Uganda tuzukuke tuzukuke
yes,
tutandika okunyiiga omuntu
yes,
kasa akola ebikyamu babire accountable to us kubanga ba leaders balina kubera ba servant baffe.
Yes,
so leader inaena avayo na government is not serving you eyo sign twandibadde twasi tukadda ne tugamba okay okoze kyokola kati twagala abo abajja okuwuliriza ffe abajja okusavinga abantu bana Uganda.
Yes,
so bana Uganda twebereremo
yes,
tuzokuke tunyiige tulina okuyiga okunyiiga obulungi bwaffe humbleness yaffe kindness yaffe bana abakulembeze gye batwalanga weakness yaffe buli we balabanga tuli ize nga bayisa buli kimu kye baagala nga bayisa nga babba buli kimu kye baagala kubanga ffe tubeera ize tusirika tetwagala buvuyo naye ke kaseera tulabire ku bantu abalala tusituke nga bannayuganda tudimandi.
Hello everyone, good evening. Demiki is as always coming. Name of the program today, the news is going to be called Add Facts Together. So I'm going to be always adding facts. I always done that because I believe evidence-based is the way to make a credible argument. So the news today, I'm going to give you three types of news. The first one, we had a presser at Kamosha headquarters where we had a remembrance for all Ugandans who were killed on 18th and 19th of November. The government claims 54, but the reason they are probing up Daily News Monitor newspaper is because they reported they died over 232 people. So for them, they have put the number down to 54. And the news plus to that because of our constant demonstration, constant talking about that, Daily Monitor has decided that they are going to serialize the events, how they happened. But they said according to how the government reported that. So that is a victory for activists, because we have been on through that, we are demonstrating, we are talking about that, and we started a good hashtag for November, which is M7, NOV November, Massacre Uganda. So keep using that, because now the media has been quiet, and now because we are talking about issues, they are also forced to talk about issues which are affecting our country. And another news I'm giving you, Copagal, Betty Kamia, has probed up 18 people in the UBOS, Uganda Bureau of Statistics, 18 because of victimizing staff or corruption, blah, blah, and it's laughable. And another news I got from Sarah Opendi, the ex-minister of health, she said that there are more thieves in NRM than anywhere. So it's laughable. So my topic today, I'm going to talk about how politicizing everything has affected, has confused the Ugandans. The reason why I'm talking about this, Ugandans, they are being caught up to understand their rights, to divide politics from public services, to divide civil servants from being partisan, from being a political party in government. So if I could tell you this, it's like people, they are being confused. They don't know. You can find that somebody is crying everything to Museveni. Museveni give us, Museveni let my son out, Museveni give us a road, Museveni my son is sick, because the reason Museveni has made this on purpose, to politicize everything so that you start begging him, so that you start seeing all these things in him. So that is what dictators do. They oppose democracy. Democracy should be different. That for me, who comes from Lusakara Mese, I've got things available for me in Lusakara Mese. If I ever need to get anywhere near politics, I can go to my local council and speak to the councillor, speak to the district commissioner. But what has happened is that Museveni has politicized everything in Uganda. And when we look at examples, I'm going to give you so many examples. I'm sure everybody has got all these examples. So that really confuses people to understand that a government is meant to deliver service. A government is meant to be doing this. And what confuses them, they start asking government, will you do for this? But actual sense, politicians are meant to deliver services. That is their work. Number one, they make laws the parliamentary. And those laws, they make it easier for how the service is going to be delivered. So people, they are confused a lot. You find people all the time, they are begging. They are begging. We had Nubia Niri, thank you, Nubia, is telling you what politics is about. And if you could find now, it has become a crime to talk about politics in Uganda. It has become a crime to wear a red beret or NUP beret. It has become a crime to support Robert Chagulan. It has become a crime to support any other political party other than national Resistance, whatever, NRM, National Robbers Movement. I forgot the other name, the actual name. So when you look at people now in Uganda, they are very confused. But we want a generation to grow up when they know that they are growing up, education is there. They don't need to beg, they don't need to ask. We want people to know that when they go to hospital, they're entitled to see a doctor, they're entitled to have medicine, they're entitled to be admitted on the bed. When my sister was dying, he died in a very, very horrible state that I have said, I wish Ruth Acheng and Diana Trine should go through the same, because my sister died of cancer. And when she was admitted, we were asked to bring the bed. We were asked to bring the mattress, but she's dying of cancer last days. And we had to wait for somebody to die for my sister to get a bed. So we cannot be beggars, believe. That is what is happening. That politician now, if you could look at this, when you look at how everything has been politicized, look at this. Politics has become a career. That people now, they sell their houses, they pay money to voters, become member of parliament, because becoming member of parliament is going to give you a big chunk of earning. So that is confusing people. That is running away from responsibility. As a member of parliament, you are supposed to make a law. You are supposed to hold our government accountable. Look at the money which is well spent. So politicizing everything is confusing people. Just like you can see, we've got member of parliament for their good heart. They have got ambulances. But it's a government responsibility to buy ambulances, because in the budget, it is well accounted for. Money is allocated to buy ambulances. So it shouldn't be the member of parliament. But so far, given the situation in Uganda, member of parliament, they had to do it. So people, they are confused. They don't know whom to ask. They're being intimidated. They are being threatened. They are being broken, because that's how the dictator wants it. The dictator wants to blacken your eyes. The dictator wants to make it everything that you go through him. And that is how it is. So you don't separate a member of parliament, their role and responsibility. You don't separate the government, what they are meant to be doing. You don't, people, they are really, look at these cases. You know, I want to give you some of these examples. Look at how this political hijack, how it is happening. Every athlete or sportswoman and man who have got like a win award, when they come back to Uganda, they are being welcomed in NRM ranks. But it shouldn't be that way. So they are confusing. When you speak to children in Brazil, they grow up to be like a Pele, play football like Pele, wear number 10 on their back shirts. But they don't want to be Pele because of the politics. So the politics is going to be there because it controls our daily lives. But it can't be that politics is stepping in the way that you are not living a normal life. When we see those Olympians who come from Japan, they won gold, is it Chipotogei? He ended up in State House wearing yellow. They wear yellow shoes. They wear NRM jersey. They wear everything. Politicize. It shouldn't be that way. We saw the RDC, was it Imbale or Lira, is wearing NRM. So we have to separate the word civil servants and NRM members. We have to, this is why NUP is talking about inclusive, so that you are going to be employed regardless what party you are affiliated to. As long as you got the credits, as long as you got the qualification, NUP is going to employ civil servants. It's not going to employ national unity platform members only, because we believe that Uganda is for all. But as it stands for now, there are so many ways you can see how Museveni and the dictator is confusing Uganda. He's not giving public services, and he comes and says, "Nateka we bikufuru," like the Lord Mayor. And he comes and say, I'm not going to give you I'm not going to give you services because you did not vote very well. So let us look at these examples, and you can see how everything has been politicized. Let us look at SOP. These are the rules we have brought in place to help us deal with the COVID or support ourselves from contracting HIV, for contracting COVID. But what it has happened, that they were brought to bring down NUP, to stop opposition. They brought them to their convenience. Ruth Achieng was the first one to break it. So that shows you that it was being politicized. It wasn't brought in for the good health, because we saw rallies for NRM primaries. We saw rallies during the campaign, but they don't want to see that as from opposition. So they are politicizing everything they want to do and stop other people. Look at the POMA. The law that deals with the public, whatever. They brought it in. NRM, they can do whatever they want. Museveni drove his car from Ruachitura to Kampala. No one stopped the rallies. No one stopped Museveni. So politicizing, this POMA should be brought in the interest of Uganda, not in the interest of stopping opposition. So let us look another example. Let us look on local leaders. For me, I'm a great supporter of 10 house chief, Mayumba Kumi, which was there. 10 families, you know each other, you have a leader, you know, and you work in your community and you integrate, you deal with other villagers. But what happened? The Museveni brought in local councils, RC 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Which is more, you find RC1 is looking about 100 houses. That is too much. We don't have a computer. In Uganda, 10 houses are well managed. Somebody has a child, you know them, the date of birth, but as it happens for now, it's diluted. And this is why it is so difficult now to trace somebody, criminals, to trace, like you can have a house girl, she will tell you, I come from Rusakarwa Mese, Demi Giza is my mother. She'll make up everything. You can't trace. But if we had these 10 houses, chief, leader, it is easier to trace this person back. And also, when we see politicizing, when you look at the actual role and responsibility for local councils, should be able to deal with the issues concerning their locals, local people. But as it happens for now, it's like RC for NUP, RC for NRM, RC for what? Politicizing. Local councils should not be affiliated to any political party. Should be chosen to just to lead their community, look after issues in their community. But what happens for now, you find the RC1 is for NRM. RC1 is for this political party. For what? You are standing as a local leader to deal with the issues affecting your local community. Actually, there should be even volunteers. This is how Uganda was in the beginning. But since Museveni has come into power, he's politicized everything, which it shouldn't be like that. And now they have scrapped out the Mayumba Kumi. And 2 years ago, I was buying a land in somewhere not far away from Nansan. And then they were writing people names to bring back that Mayumba Kumi Chigoma. So that one is not what it should be. And if I could remember the young man called Komugisha, who said that he can kill for the president. That was the head of the crime preventers. The head of crime preventers, which is auxiliary units. They have come in power and they have made everything because of them, their militarization. They prefer to make everything political. political. And if you can see now, this young man says, I can kill for the president. It shouldn't be that way. Not politicize. You are recruited as a crime preventer. Carry your duties as a crime preventer. Listen, Ati Nanga, when he's talking, they were asking him, why would you cancel Bobby Wine's concerts? And you leave Baby Cool. And he said, because the head of what? Powers from above. They are the one which instructed. That is not right. That is confusing people, because as it stands for now, people, they have got opinion that they want change. People, they have got opinion of supporting another political party. But because of the conditions for them to get what they want, it's like you have to be NRM. And they get confused. And then when people, they get confused, they cannot stand up. They cannot stand up to the monster. They cannot stand up and demonstrate. Listen to this now. Politicize. I read one of the religious leader who blamed young people that they go to campaign and they go to demonstrate. But he is not brave enough to condemn those people who are killing people. Thursday is coming. The demonstration we have, Thursday is coming. We are going to remember Ugandans who were killed on 18th and 19th of December. But they cannot condemn the perpetrators. But what they do, they condemn people who were fighting and defending their rights. That is what the confusion is. People, they don't understand that people, you need to defend your rights. You need to stand up. And what they are telling people, it's like people who are saying, oh, Robert Chagrin is too young to become a president. Button, who is a young man? Who is a young man? Somebody, 39 years, with his 4 children, somebody with a business, Busabala, somebody who has been singing for 20 years, somebody who has been prominent as a political leader within 4 years, somebody who stands on his leg and stands high and tall against that gas, that tear gas. And you say he's too young? I think you should come away from there. So that is how people who want to control you. That's how they do. They bring it, oh, you are too young. And Ugandan, we have to be mindful that people, they say, people power revolution is for young people, not for old. No, it's a generational cause, because as we stand today, no one is happy about the services, how Uganda is being run. So we find ourselves that we are inclined, we belong to the generation. We don't need to say that you are old, you are not about generation, you are too young, you are for generation. What I need is for you young people to tell me today, if you call yourself young, come up, inventive, come up, dynamic, come up, active. Let me call you that, wake up in 6 o'clock, go here and here, and you walk off your toes, then I'll know you are young. Come up with new ideas, but then you are too young. What about if you keep on saying you are too young? You are in this struggle for 3 years. And if we go to next election, you'll be plus 8 years. How old are you going to be? Are you going to still too young? So politicizing everything is confusing Ugandans. Look at the word youth in Uganda. It's being misused. It's being misused. You find somebody 30, 35. Anita was 35, she was still Minister of Youth. Anita, you find people 45, 50, and they say they are youth. You look at their head, look at their board, and they are not scared to say that they are youth. For me, somebody I know that is a youth is between 14 and 20 years. But then I find people in Uganda, they are saying youth, youth, I'm a youth. And I say, what is that? So political. Politicizing everything is confusing Ugandans, and people, they are like, they don't understand. They don't understand their rights. They don't really, they cannot separate that a government is meant to give them public services, whether they support their political party, whether they don't support the political party. What they see is like, we have SACCO. We have SACCO. Oh, when you go to find out SACCO, SACCO is full of NRM, okay? Then nepotism. Then you find the problem. Museveni is the president. His wife is a minister. His children, they are everywhere. Saleh is like this. Wealth creation. It is confusing people that employment is for everybody. That job creation should be for everybody. Should not be selective. That is what is confusing people. And what does NUP talk about this? NUP has got the five, they don't change, the five aims that is going to be people-centered problem, governance, that we are going to enjoy the economic growth. We are going to access the all the services. They are going to be equal. They are going to be affordable. They are going to be accessible. And it's going to be quality. So we are... NUP is looking at sharing economic growth. NUP is looking at East Minos. NUP is looking at peace, domestic and international. And it's going to deal, as I said to you yesterday, about something to do with the rule of law. They are going to deal with everybody equally. No one is going to escape because powers from above, because he is a brother of so-and-so, he's a sister of so-and-so. No, we want every Ugandan to feel proud. We want every Ugandan to come in Uganda, to be in Uganda, and get their rights. But what is confusing people, they go to apply for the ID, they have to bribe for the papers, for the signatures, for the documents, for the entry, for the collection. That is no way people they are getting. It's about being confused. The thing is that when you know your rights, no one can stand in the way. You say, I want this. I'm Demi Kiza. I come for my ID. You sign, you take it. But what is confusing people? They have to pay money. And where does that take us? The problem we have is that Museveni is a dictator. Museveni has brought in, he's compromised everything. He has added all the powers I talked about yesterday, the legislature, the executive and the judiciary together. Look at this. You go to the, look this, at this example now. We have now people, general, local people being taken to military courts. And it's being politicized. You can hear this man from military court when he said that he cannot release these people until when Museveni says so. And the Supreme Court decided, Mr. Guti, Supreme Court decided that people, they should be taken in a civilian court, not in a military court. But it still says until he gets the power from above. We can see Segrinya, they are into prison. But until they can hear the word powers from above, I don't know if these people, they are making up. Because sincerely, when you are professional, you don't look for powers above. So the confusion it is creating in people is quite big. People, we can underestimate this, but it's quite very, very big. We need to know the impact. We need to know how to overcome this. And the NUP is looking, is setting examples. We have our president-elect, Kyagulanyi Robert Ssentamu, by 54.1. And then he has got branches. Not everything now comes from Robert. No, he has appointed the deputies. If you want, approach them. We have the Secretary General, different. Spokesman and deputy, different. Leader of opposition, different. Member of parliament, different. Local councils, different. So it's like, before you go to the hierarchy, start from bottom. Start from your local councillor. Speak to them, start from the young people, the youth. I wanna let us exercise that for us to take away this dictatorship, because we are not creating a monster, but we are building the way the new Uganda is going to be. For me, I hate to see the old Uganda in how we practice, but we have to make it that the old Uganda is going to vanish and is going to disappear. So look at this one now. When they came to elect Makerere University guilty president, we used to elect anybody without any being public affiliated to any political party. Now people, they come out when they are open to any political party. So where we are now, we need to look at this as something that some people, they are confused. They are confused in a way they cannot stand up for Museveni. Museveni says the bill has got to go through, and they say, oh, the president said, oh, the road is not bad. We wait for Museveni. I want to speak to Museveni. I want to see Museveni. My daughter is like this. I need to see Museveni. No, we need to know who is responsible for, because Museveni is not the only one in Uganda. We need to respect the outcome of election, that we elected the leaders, and those leaders, they are to represent us. In what perspective is what we have to identify. It's like we have women MPs. For me, is a position, if you ask me, that I want to scrap, because so far I haven't seen a woman MP doing what they are meant to be doing, because we have got issues affecting women. Women, they are suffering domestic violence. Women, there is gender inequality. Women, they live on the lower level of economy. So we have children being abused. Nina this morning was talking about teenager pregnancy. I haven't seen an MP coming in my constituents, condemning that or highlighting that. But as we stand for now, it's about 50,000 teenager people who are what? Who are pregnant. I haven't seen a woman MP talk about that. So who is going to talk about that? So we need to look at these people. Who is responsible? Is it that you are lacking funds? Look at your local council. Look at Matia Kasaja. Where we are now, it's like everything almost seven. Listen at Matia Kasaja saying, oh, if I don't do this, you kill my neck. We cannot accept that, and we cannot keep on thinking that way. So we have to look at this. Politicizing is killing Uganda. You can see job creation now. It is through like NRM. It is through politics. It shouldn't be that too. Then the courts of law, instead of being civilian, now they are being turned into military. It is a political persecution. It is confusing people where to go. We should be in a Uganda which is well-structured, that you know that Demi has been arrested, you're going to find me in a civilian court. You are not going to find me in the army court. But what they are doing now, they are taking people to military court. So they are confusing people. Museveni comes out and say, you vote wrongly, you will not get services. No, don't be confused. Services, they are not for the president to decide. Services, they come from the Uganda revenue. It's the money they collect on behalf of Uganda. It's the Uganda Revenue Authority who collects the money. And they give it to the government to decide how they are distributing that money. So that money is not from seven. But as we stand for now, people, they are confused. Everything they say, Museveni is confusing you by giving a cash handout. Museveni is confusing you by being like he walks with sacks of bags. It shouldn't be. Money should be in structures, financial structures, mobile money, Bank of Uganda banks or checks. That is how it is. Listen to this. What Museveni does. They've got like propagandists. Look at Tamale Mirundi. He comes and says, oh, Mpuga is for NRM because He's using the girl. He's the car he's driving is from seven. But what he's not telling them, our constitution gives the leader of opposition has got entitlement. And the parliament also adds some entitlement to the leader of opposition. This is what they do to confuse people. Propagandists for NRM. Look at them. They have created bloggers association. For what? Bloggers association. You don't create. Okay, you can have it. But then it is for Uganda. It's not for NRM. But God is good. Bloggers association was created on the day that God gave them a test. On that day when they created that bloggers association is the day when Fred Rumbuye disappeared. They would have come out and say, okay, Fred Rumbuye, a blogger affiliated to NRM, went missing. Full stop. What they want, these people jubilating, saying it should be this and this. And so they were heavily tested. And when it came out, these so-called bloggers, when you were a blogger, you stand up for other bloggers. They would have said Fred has been released. Simple statement. But what they do, they just go on jubilation. Political, politicizing everything. And some, they use it to escape their crimes. Look at Ismael Oelex. He has admitted killing somebody. And he has been calling on violence, killing people. And he's been homophobic. And what we stand for now, he's never been apprehended. He's never been charged. We saw him in prison one day and he didn't go to prison. So politicizing has brought on a lot of confusion, but NUP has got the answer. Manifesto speaks very well. The objectives, they are very well. People-centered government. We are not going to move away from that. We want everything to be centered to the people. But what is happening for NRM is how they get the best out of it. How can you tell me that RDC can stop somebody, a presidential material, presidential personnel? How can they have that power? Everything is politicized. Everything is politicized. RDC, NRM. RCC, NRM. DC, NRM. OC, NRM. Everything, NRM, NRM. And also listen to this. People now, when you talk about job creation, instead of creating jobs for Ugandans, they create jobs for NRM cadre. Before recruiting you as a police, UPDF, security, wherever, they recruit you, they make sure you are NRM, and when you come out, you just beat people for fun. So this is how they are confusing the whole nation, the young generation, that they are looking for job, they are very, very vulnerable, and then they are taking advantage. And by the time they bring them out, they already turned their head into NRM. Their head, they are going to defend. They are going to defend the NRM. They are going to defend Museveni. But it shouldn't be that way that they are going to defend Museveni. It should be they are going to defend Uganda. And Museveni can go anytime. Now look at Uganda. We want, as it stands for now, we want change of government, which is rightly so in any rule of law and in our constitution. But now people, they say, no, you have to let Museveni. Hey, government, yeah, Museveni. Tojikwata. Confusing minds. People, they are confused. They no longer separate the two, what you can benefit from the two. We can say change of government and Museveni has got to go. It doesn't matter whether it's good, whether it's bad, but the idea is change of government. And also our rights. Do you go to hospital and you don't find medication and you keep quiet? Because now it's like we are in NRM. Look after yourself. They don't give you public service. They don't give you any services. So you are there confused. Instead of asking, go back and say to your MP, I'm not voting you. I went to Masaka Hospital. There was no medication. I went so and so there was. And look at this. Funerals. Government kills your person, your family member, and then they come and give you condolences for 20 million and you take it. How dare can you take it? Are you confused? The blood of your family, you say it doesn't matter, you better take money. You use that money within 6 months and then it's gone. And then the ghost of your family, your sister, is there in you are being haunted. Confusion. For me, I see confusion in people because we are failing to separate. We are failing to separate politics from normal life. Listen to this, comrades. I want you to know this, that we are all, we want change. But it doesn't take away that we have got hobbies and interests. People, they get confused. A person like me, I like traveling a lot. When I work, 60% of my income are prepared to go for holiday. So if I go for holiday, you're going to tell me that I'm not that. Like what we saw, Nobianili got married. So many people got married and then people, they were like NUP part after part. No, normal life has got to go on. Normal life has got to go on. In my house, I got somebody who works with the biggest football club. But that person, both of us, we support Liverpool. But that club is not what we support. And it tends to work for them. He does everything, marketing, whatever. But sometimes they give him 10% from those brands. They invite him to go on occasions. They invite him to go, like, to go for the football matches. And then we go together. It doesn't mean that we have changed from Liverpool to support those people. No, we don't. So let us not be like we are taking away people from their interest. For me, I'd rather manage you with your interest and then I'd rather sell you that we need the change, because it will be a lie for you to say, oh, Demi, I'm going to take you away if you are like you are fighting for change. You are not going to support Liverpool. You are not going to go to, you are not going to go on holiday. Next week, my living hero, Tina Turner, 23rd November is her birthday. And it's going to be me, bananas. So it doesn't mean that. Let us really separate things. Let us also allow other people to be normal, to be normal in their lives. Let us maybe remind them, be mindful. Let us look at people when they get married that, okay, it's part of their lives. But it's like some of the positions, they do require some, like you have really sacrificed. Somebody like mine, my hero number one is Nelson Mandela, was in prison for 27 years. He's not like Ongom. Ongom was in the ICC. And by the time they have condemned it to whatever, he was seeing his wife. And even he had a baby in the ICC in the Netherlands. That is how it is. So confusion, politics in Uganda. Everything in Uganda has been politicized. But it shouldn't be that. We should separate politics from other things. But politics runs the world or the life that we are. That is what it is. But it doesn't make us beggars believe. So this is what I said yesterday, that we must have a rule of law. And we must, a rule of law is a bedrock, is a foundation whereby you can have all those service delivery. And once you have them, that's being a normal. We want people to grow up the way I want to bring up, like people, they can have IDs, they can have maybe teen, without any apprehension, without any bother. They're going to come naturally. But in Uganda, to have a teen, to have a Nina, you need like so much identification. It shouldn't be that way. We are looking at a new Uganda, NUP, the promise, the proposal to transform Uganda. You've heard our legislative agenda, which is good. NRM has stolen our COVID proposal. Fair enough, it's okay, but they need to acknowledge that. So when we look at all this, it's like everything has been politicized. Another example I want to give you, Freddy Rumbuye applied for a Ugandan passport 2 years ago, but it wasn't issued. He hasn't had a reply. Nkunyingi told us that he's probing up the embassy in Turkey or the immigration in Uganda, why they haven't issued Fred a passport. So because it is being politicized, you find that even ambassadors, if you are in diaspora, you go to your embassy, they will not attend to you as they are meant to attend to you. But the reality, they are there to represent you and represent the interest of your nation. If you live like in Turkey, the consulate, like this man in Mobiru Madness, is meant to attend to you. You can go to your embassy. I don't have a ticket to go back to Uganda. They must give it to you. I don't have food. They must give it to you. I don't have a travel document. They must give them to you. I need to speak to my family. That is what they are because they have the money. That is what they are. But what we find now, we find that all these embassies, NRM has planted all these people, as said about job creation. Instead of being civil servant, they just appoint NRM. And those NRM, they are the people who have failed in their constituency. They give them, do you want to be an ambassador, or we give you 300 million? So we have all these people who are below par. They are ambassadors, but they don't know what they are doing. They are there for them to be like a stopcock for NRM. They are gatekeeper for NRM. They are looking for people. Demi Kiza, you come, they say, you were here for demonstration. So we are not going to give you a passport. Oh, you were here for demonstration. If we give you a visa, we are going to send your details to the airport and then they'll catch you. So it's like they are breaching even confidentiality. When you apply for a visa, you are not meant to share my details. It's the immigration. Look at Entebbe Airport when you arrive. When you arrive in Entebbe Airport, we have security people. We don't have immigration people. Security turned into immigration. So you find that anything that happens for them, they say security, you have to get like army into the airport. It shouldn't be that way. We should have immigration officers who understands what a visa is, who understands what a passport is, who understands what type of visa you are required for, who understands your application. But we are in a confusion. But well, for me, I'm quite very happy that NUP intends to change all this. NUP wants to transform Uganda because of our ideology. It's people power, which is people-centered governance, that we are going to be the people consulted. We are going to be the people benefiting. We are going to be the people that drive force. We are going to be the people to air our views and be listened. This is why we must be good listeners. We must not dismiss people. We must be good listeners all the time. So as we are in November, remember Thursday and Friday, we are going to remember people who have been killed in Uganda since Museveni went in the bush, since he went 1980, more than half a million they died in Luwero. People, they are dying every day. Then we have Kasese massacre, over 100. We are having people dying, 18th and 19th, they have died. During campaign, they have died. Post-election, they have died. This election, they have died. And people, they are still dying. And people, they are still being killed. We have got so many people. So remember, on Thursday, wherever you are, we are going to remember that. Those who live in the United Kingdom, there is a demonstration outside the Ugandan embassy. That is Trafalgar Square, between from 12 p.m. to 6 p.m. orderly and no violence, nothing but demonstration to mark all those people who died. And they remember that politics is going to be there. It's a way we have to achieve some of the things we want to transform in Uganda. But we shall never mix politics with other things to confuse people. But we shall lay the rule of law as our benchmark, that people, they are going to be what they are. We are going to live side by side. You don't need to know that I support NUP. I can tell you that. Myself, we want people to grow up like you speak about yourself. You say, I'm Demi Kiza. I am my mother. I like music. I like so and so, blah, blah, blah. I'm conservative 90% and I'm liberal, a little bit liberal. And then we want people to be like that. We don't want people to keep things like, oh, you cannot tell people what you are. No. We want to be free. We don't want, like now religion has been politicized. You find that Bujingo talks about everything that happens in politics. He doesn't care people praying in his church in mud, but he's always talking about Segirinya. He's talking about Bobby Wine. He's talking about opposition. This is why leader of opposition is making inroads. He visited all those people. Bujingo is visiting people in Ghana, is visiting what? So that people, they begin to know that politics is not what they think. Politics is for them and it is something that is there in their daily life, but they can move on and do other things. So fellow Ugandans, as I finish for now, I thank you very much for watching me. I thank you so much for your comments. I thank you very, very much. But let us take this as so, so important that the confusion you see in people is because everything has been politicized. And who has done that? It has been Museveni. Why did he do it? Is to make it easier for him to rule the people, because all the people now, they look at to him as the answer, as the solution. But however, I have good news. NUP is the answer as for now, because we have a manifesto that is relevant, that is going to address all the issues for Uganda. Not because the all the issues and the all, because NUP is about the new Uganda. New Uganda, we're going to go back. We're going to reform. We're going to restore. We're going to do whatever we can. We're going to have civil servants. We are not going to have people who are confused when they are civil servants, but then they act on because of NRM party, because of power from above. So I thank you very much for listening to me. Sorry for the echo. And remember, other speakers are coming. Yesterday, we had so many speakers on a Choto platform, which I'm proud about, which I'm pleased about. We shall catch up with each other. I'll come back on Thursday to remember all the dead souls of Uganda since 1980. We need to remember them. And that is what that I had to say. If you really have something to say, there is a hashtag I'm gonna pin up on my Facebook. There is a poster. I had technical problem as I tried to upload my poster, then things, they did not work out, but I will still have time to practice that tomorrow. Salute. People power, our power, NUP everywhere, NUP. Thank you.